My Uncle Leo came back from the Korean War with two medals on his chest and no toes on his left foot. He was captured by the enemy and spent 2 months in a prison camp. Most folks thought he was some kind of hero. Uncle Leo didn't feel that way. He'd lost the toes to frostbite. Wasn't the same as getting them shot off, he said. But he understood how sometimes people need to believe in heroes more than the truth. So pretty soon he made up a whole different story. I asked him once why men fought so much, why they went to war. He said he believed it was because no man wants to be thought of as a coward by other men. That's why they fight. That's why they drink so much. That's why they don't ever cry. Uncle Leo said the biggest trouble with being a hero was trying to find shoes that fit.
Come in.
I'm not late, am I? I thought you said 10:30.
You're on time. Clifford was early. Forrest, this is
Clifford McFreely.
Clifford is the new counsel for Dwight Tully.
Pleasure.
Mr. McFreely?
My uncle, Randall Sawyer, asked me to send his regards.
He's still practicing in Greene County?
Yes, sir. Just won a seat in the state Senate, too.
Mm-hmm.
Cup of coffee.
No, thanks. So, Stuart, why are we here?
I thought that we could save the taxpayers some time and money.
How's that?
I asked Judge Thompson to dismiss the Tully case.
On what grounds?
Lack of evidence.
I don't bring about a murder charge unless I can prove it.
And you believe you can?
Yes, Clifford.
Well, Forrest, I don't. I don't think you got a chance in hell of proving anything. So why would you possibly want to proceed? You don't have a witness. Can't place him at the scene. You don't have his prints on the gun. And you, sir, don't have a motive.
Calm down, Clifford.
It's just the three of us. Unless you're ruling now. Pre-trial hearing is in 2 days.
We already know the outcome.
We do?
He has nothing. Everybody knows that.
Mr. McFreely, the judge and jury get to try this case first. You did learn that in law school, didn't you?
Yes, sir. I also learned there's some cases should never go to trial.
Well, this one is. See you in 48 hours. Forrest? See you in court.
In 780, the Carthaginians, who hadn't forgotten the trouncing Hamilcar had received at Himera, decided to invade Sicily. They launched an attack with 18,000 men and an armada of 1,400 ships. Imagine how magnificent that was. The Mediterranean sun gleaming on 10,000 bronze shields. Strong, sinewy bodies of invincible young warriors. Spears held high. Swords lusting for battle. The taste of sweet revenge on their lips. Remember Himera. Remember Himera. Remember Himera. And leading this parade was a young fellow named Hannibal. Hamilcar's grandson.
Oh, I came from Alabama with my banjo on my knee.
No, you weren't.
Yes, I was. Plus, you can't even subtract yet.
I can, too.
Oh, that's enough now. Honey, what's your name?
Patty.
Well, not all of us feel like singing all of the time, do we?
No.
All right, then. Now, tomorrow is Mother's Visiting Day, and I do expect John Morgan and everybody else to bring their very best singing voices with them. Okay?
Okay.
Now, Miss Markle left a note for me to remind everyone to wear white shirts or blouses, black slacks or skirts, and boys wear ties. I know your mothers will be very proud of you. You're going ready to sing the next song? Gonna
yes.
be ready? Okay, well, let's do it. Here we go.
Ready?
Getting to know you.
Hey, I understand Judge Thompson was dying to toss out the Tully case.
I understand you once had a future.
You heard about that too, huh?
Listen carefully now, because it's coming from the source. I'm going to trial. I'm going to get a conviction.
I also understand that once the case is dismissed, they're going to ask for a full investigation of your office.
I didn't know Mr. McFreely was old enough to get elected.
Nah, he's just trying to wreck you is all. You know, I don't know if I should admire you or pity you.
And on that note, if you'll excuse me.
Look, if it's my fault, getting you involved in this predicament, sorry.
Nobody's perfect.
Nobody is. Lord knows we all got something to hide. If I hear any more talk, I'll call.
You do that.
I think it goes like this.
That can't be right. Let me look at the directions. Maybe it needs more glue.
I thought your voice might be hungry.
Thanks, Lily. Thanks.
Don't get that stuff on anything. Logan, does your mother know you're here?
Yes, ma'am.
Good, huh?
Yeah. Want to spend the night Friday?
Sure, if it's okay. My mom will call your mom.
No. What do you mean?
Well, my mom's not here.
Where is she?
Say, the old man was a good friend of yours, wasn't he?
Out west.
That's right.
What's she out there for? That's where all the horses are.
Right now, it's kind of hard to say.
What does she do with them?
She rides them in the rodeos.
Like Alice Oakley?
Yep.
Does she shoot guns, too?
Sure, when she's on her horse, too.
What's her horse's name?
Trotty.
Does she know John Wayne?
Yep, and Gabby Hayes, too.
Wow.
I'll ask my daddy if I can spend the night.
When your mom comes home, does he bring her horse?
Sure, she always does.
She rides it right down our street, too. Wow, that's neat.
Yep.
A clerk at Swanson's department store said Tully tried on a jacket. He also looked at a couple of hats, but didn't buy anything.
What about his behavior? Was he nervous, acting strange?
Nobody said so.
What time did he leave the store?
The clerk didn't remember.
What time did he go back to work at the mill that day?
I don't know.
Why not?
Look, Forrest, this isn't my only case. I got other work to do, too.
Whatever else you have can wait. I want you to spend every minute on this. I'm going to court in a couple of days. I want you to talk to Winston Kreider again.
He's not going to tell me anything I don't know. Besides, I don't want to keep bothering him.
What is it, McKeeson? Don't you want to see Dwight Tully convicted? Or do you think it's all right to shoot someone down in the middle of an intersection just to shut him up?
No, I don't.
Then do your job!
You know, when this is all over and decided one way or the other, you're going to be gone to the Capitol. But I'll still be here, trying to get along with these people, hoping that their kids will play with mine. that the women will want to talk to my wife. And maybe somebody will still shake my hand after church.
Sit down. I want you to copy the first 10 pages of chapter 6 60 times, and I want 5 pages on my desk tomorrow morning about the Battle of Troy. Get started.
No.
You better think twice about that, mister. Walk out that door, you're out of here.
You got that right.
Don't be stupid.
I'm not stupid. Don't you ever call me stupid.
You've struggled like Sisyphus to keep up with the C students, but you've done it. And up till now, at least you've tried. I can't tie you to the mast, and I don't know what siren calls to you, but resist her with all your will. Because you're headed for the rocks.
I already told your assistant everything I know.
I know you did, Winston, but I wanted to ask you a few more questions. Since you were working at the jail on the day McDaniel was transferred. You ever have tonsillitis, measles, scarlet fever?
What?
Persistent cough, insomnia, blood in your urine.
After McDaniel complained of stomach pains, what did you do?
I called the hospital and I talked to a doctor.
Why weren't you in the car with him?
I don't know.
You ever suffer from dizzy spells, fainting, shortness of breath?
What?
Is there any history of insanity in your family?
I gotta get back to work.
Sit down. You don't move till I tell you. Now sit down.
I am district attorney of Breland County, and I can kick your butt from here to Appaloosa, and nobody can stop me. Understood, Peanut? Do you understand?
Yes.
Good, then. Now, do you have high blood pressure, heart disease,
rashes, or abnormalities of the skin?
Do you? No.
We seem to be making progress. That's good. But what I need to know is, do you ski? Simple question, doesn't take much thought. Do you ski?
No.
Have you ever skied in your entire life?
No, sir.
I need your answer by tomorrow.
Practice today.
Yep, and I'm gonna miss it again tomorrow.
Why?
Cause I quit school.
What? Why?
Cause I don't need it.
I heard Zolly kicked you out of your chair today.
Oh, yeah, that's right, he did.
So is that why you're doing this?
Well, let's just say it knocked some sense into me. Started to see things clearly.
Like what?
That was supposed to be done yesterday.
Well, I'm almost finished.
Hi, Mr. Slocum.
It was supposed to already been finished.
By the time you go inside, take a shower and have a beer, it will be. Quit school today. I'm gonna be a working man.
So I'm finally getting rid of you.
Yeah, that's right. Till I get enough money to get my own place.
You ain't good for nothing except nigger work. Because you don't have a brain in your body. I want you out at the end of the week.
You got it.
The day you were born, the first time I saw you, I swore I'd get drunk every night of my life.
And you have, too.
By the end of the week.
You know John Wayne, miss?
I think in California.
Not in Texas?
I don't believe so. You want some sweet potatoes for dinner, John Morgan?
Yes, ma'am. Al Soakley lives in Texas, doesn't she?
Who's Alice Oakley?
She's a cowgirl.
I believe you mean Annie Oakley, John Morgan. I don't know where she lives. I don't follow the cowgirls too closely.
Well, she rides horses and rodeos, ropes doggies, shoots Indians, and everything. She wears cowboy boots and a beautiful cowboy hat.
Sounds like she's really something.
She is. Have you ever been to a rodeo?
Once. At the state fair.
Did they have horses?
All sorts of horses. The cowboys are trying to ride them. Sometimes with the saddle, sometimes without. Bareback is what you call it.
Was there any cowgirls?
Yes, I remember. There's this big parade on horses when the rodeo started. And all the cowgirls would ride in, holding flags and waving at the crowd.
Do you happen to remember any cowgirl names, like Annie Oakley, only another one?
No, I don't. But I guess they have names just like everybody else.
Oh, no, they don't.
Why is that?
Because they're cowgirls. They have to have a really special name.
You eating tonight?
I ate lunch.
Nathan, do you know where Annie Oakley lives?
Who's that?
She's a cowgirl. She shoots things.
I don't know. Probably California.
Not in Texas?
No, you little idiot. She's a movie star, and movie stars live in California.
Hey!
Don't mention it.
John Morgan, go on upstairs and change out of those pants. I'd like to iron them before school tomorrow.
But I'm not.
You're not what?
Nothing.
Then go and do what you're told. Is something the matter, John Morgan?
No, ma'am.
You wanted to see me?
Winston, come on in. Sit down. Come on.
Eat. I ain't hungry.
Eat.
You're from the northern part of the state.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Is your cousin Dwight Tully from there, too?
A different holler, sir.
Finished?
Yes, sir.
When you were living up there in that holler, Winston, eating eggs in the morning and chicken at night, did you ever stop? Ask yourself the question.
What question is that, sir?
Which came first? My chicken or your egg?
answer me!
No, sir, I didn't.
Did your cousin?
I don't know.
Yes or no?
No.
There's an argument to be made from both sides, you know.
I'm feeling a little short of breath here.
That's because you eat too fast.
I ain't feeling so good either.
And you should go home. Winston, I want you to promise me you won't eat too fast. Ever again.
Mrs. Yanniger will pick us up at 7 and drive us to the roller rink. Then we'll skate until 9.
Mom, come boy, you're gonna be late.
Morning, Nathan.
We'll stop at Hebert's for a soda. We'll be back by 9:25. 9:30 at the latest.
It's a school night, Fancy.
Well, what do you want to go there for? You don't skate. All you do is hang out at the snack bar and make eyes with the guys on the floor patrol.
Please, Dad, I'll do all my homework before we go.
All right, then. I guess one night won't hurt.
Thanks.
Yeah, well, I gotta go, too.
When's your next match?
Tomorrow.
Did you make your weight yet?
No, I'm a pound and a half over. I'll see you.
I don't feel so good.
What's the matter?
I'm sick.
You don't have a fever. Let me see your tongue. Nothing looks wrong. Where does it hurt?
Where?
That's right.
All over?
You gonna run upstairs and get your school clothes on. Gonna be late.
No, I don't want to.
I can see that, but it's not because you're sick.
I am too.
Come here, John Morgan. Maybe he caught a bug.
Maybe he has a test today that he doesn't want to take. Did you do your homework?
You sick, John Morgan?
Yes.
All right, then. Go on upstairs and get into bed.
That child's not sick, Mr. Bedford.
I'll come up before I go to work.
Miss Bedford, that child's not sick.
I know that.
Then why are you letting him stay home?
Because for whatever reason, he really wants to.
What if he really wants to tomorrow?
We'll worry about that then.
Okay.
Coach.
Why aren't you in class, Bedford?
I want to talk to you about Slocum.
What about him?
He quit school.
I regret he made that decision. He will too one day.
Yeah, but he could change his mind. He'd come back even if you just ask him.
I don't talk to losers, Bedford. His courage is failing. He's not fit to be a warrior anymore.
Why don't you just give him a break?
Excuse me?
Why do you have to be so hard on him all the time?
Because the world's a dangerous place, Bedford. It's full of treacherous waters and uncharted reefs. It's especially true for a fellow like Slocum. I'm surprised he doesn't tip over. A chip that large in his shoulder?
Look, his home life's a wreck. He's got nothing to hold on to but this school and our team.
Wrong. He's got you.
You're as noble as Damon to seek relief for your friend, but the thread's been cut. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got a meeting with our esteemed principal and vice principal. Remember, Bedford, he's still got you.
Stuart.
I'm not interrupting.
Absolutely not. Please.
Well, I don't normally sit down with an attorney of record the day before a pretrial. But I wanted you to know that Pierce Connors has died.
Oh, no.
Apparently a burst aneurysm while showering.
Stuart, you were such a good man. I'm so sorry to hear that.
Marvelous sense of humor. Honest, forthright, top-notch lawyer.
Yes, he was.
I heard word of it yesterday. Ended up getting into the cooking sherry last night. Anyway, I ended up in the attic, leafing through our old law school yearbook. I hadn't looked at that in 20, 25 years. We all looked young and confident.
Doesn't young plus confident equal naive?
Were we ever really that young? You know, under your picture, one of the particulars read, at times, can't see forest for the trees.
Is that right? Did it really?
Yes, it did.
Well, as you say, we were young and confident, and apparently myopic.
Are you ready for tomorrow?
I will be.
I truly hope that you're seeing clearly on this one.
I am.
Anyway, old Pierce is sorely missed.
Yes, he is.
He was a good man.
Yes, he was.
So, are you feeling any better?
I don't think so.
Ham and cheese sandwich with relish. Your favorite. Mmm. Well, if you don't want it, I guess I'll eat it. Aren't you gonna try just a little bite? John Morgan, I want to know why you didn't want to go to school today.
Because I'm sick.
Mm-hmm. About as sick as Adeline was last week when she was sick because she didn't know her lessons.
It's not that.
Then what is it?
I'm sick. My daddy said so.
Yes, he did. But that doesn't mean that you are.
I am too. I am too. You don't know nothing. You don't know.
Well, what? I understand you wanted to see me.
That's right. Dwight Tully has confessed.
What?
You heard me.
When?
Less than an hour ago.
He confessed to what?
Murdering McDaniel.
He said that?
Among other things.
So, Tully's confessed. There's more?
Apparently.
You name names?
Not yet.
So why me?
Because. Now we're even.
Hello, Logan. Don't you look spiffy?
Thank you. Is John Morgan home?
Yes, but he's sick.
Oh, that's what everyone thought.
But he's feeling better. Nah, he should be in school tomorrow.
Yes, ma'am. And would you tell him that everybody sang good, but that he was the only one that was not there?
The only one not where?
At Mother's visiting day. His mom didn't ride into town, did she?
No, she didn't.
See ya.
What the hell happened to you?
I got in a fight.
Who with?
My father.
Bourbon, straight up.
Hello, Winston. I talked to you for a minute.
Who are you?
Tucker Anderson. I'm a reporter for the Republic. Thank you. You hear the news? Your cousin Dwight Tully confessed to the McDaniel murder.
What?
Mm-hmm. Happened about an hour ago. What do you think about that?
Nothing. I don't think nothing.
Forrest Bedford told me he's gonna start naming names.
Hey, you stay away from me, you hear? Stay away.
Throw you out?
Yeah, I wanted to kill him.
What'd you use on him? Figure four?
Half Nelson and Hammerlock.
You and me is kindred spirits.
How do you mean, Coach?
I look at you, I see me. Same swagger, same mouth, same hurt. The sins of the fathers, born by their sons. Good as new. So, what are you gonna do? What's your plan?
I don't know.
You've got just as much right to live in your house as he has.
I guess. Maybe I could rent out somebody's basement. You know, like in exchange for work around the house.
I wish I could help you out, son. But the truth is, I'm leaving here for a while.
What?
I've been suspended by the Board of Education for integrating my wrestling team.
You're kidding.
They can run, son, but they can't hide. None of us can. It's coming. Southern society as we know it is on the brink of fundamental change.
Are you happy or sad about that?
Neither. I'm a pragmatist, a wrestler, rolling through each move, countering each hold. Look at life like a standing clinch. Who'll take whom down first? Want me to give you a ride home?
No, that's okay. I think I'll walk. So where are you gonna go now, Coach?
I was thinking about returning to the Citadel. It's a long time since I smelled new cut grass on a parade field. Watched the battalion colors fly in the wind.
What's that?
I want to take down what you say.
And what for?
To use in court. I'm going to get you immunity for testifying, keep you from being tried as an accessory to murder. I have to do this right. But you have to tell me everything you know.
What about my family?
I'll see they're taken care of. Shall we begin?
Well, they told McDaniel to pretend he had stomach pains that morning. So after I called Doc Elliott, I was supposed to call Dwight and tell him when McDaniel was being moved. He thought they was just going to let him escape. I didn't know they was going to kill him. I swear they never said nothing about that.
Do you think I look all right?
Just fine.
Maybe I should wear my white sweater instead.
Francie, you've changed four times now.
I want to look good. What about my green pants?
They're not ironed.
Well, you can do them real quick, couldn't you? They'll wait. I'll just go
just
tell them.
Just go, period.
Well, what about...
You look pretty. Now, get on out of here. Go.
Where's my daddy?
He called. He has to work late. He'll be along soon. Playing pretend's a lot of fun, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
As long as we know that that's what it is, just pretending. I used to pretend when I was a child that I was the Queen of Spain or a movie star. A lot of things. When I was 15, my mother died. She was sick for a little while, and she died one night, in the middle of the night. And I decided to pretend that she hadn't.
Died?
Mm-hmm. For three whole days, I pretended she was in the other room, in her bed, resting. And when I went to school, I didn't tell anyone about it. And if someone asked me, I just said she was under the weather, but that she hadn't died, even though I knew that she had. Do you ever pretend about your mother, John Morgan?
Sometimes.
sometimes.
What do you pretend?
Once I pretended that she died, but that was only one time.
Why do you pretend that?
Because if she's up in heaven with God, that's why she can't be here with me.
I'd like to ask you a favor, John Morgan.
What's that?
The next time you hurt all over, but you're not really sick, please tell me. We could do something special together, just you and me.
Okay.
Thank you.
I can't believe Zully's gone.
Yeah, he's nuts. Well, he's good nuts.
So what's gonna happen now? I mean, with the team?
I don't know. Maybe they'll get one from the girls' field hockey team. Wrestling never gets no respect.
You don't think they'll get Winchesky, do you?
Winchesky? Winchesky's a joke, man. He's the golf coach. He always wears those ugly Bermuda shorts and those black socks. He doesn't know nothing about wrestling.
He looks like Lawrence Welk.
So, what are we gonna do?
We? Does this mean you're staying?
Yeah, I guess. For the time being.
You want to do some curls?
No. I gotta go. I'd just soon face my old man sooner than later. See ya.
Now, Paul. You know, if you ever need a place to sleep, you can always come here.
Thanks. You know, life is a bitch. You finally find the one man that maybe you can talk to, and he up and leaves.
Set me up. What you did was illegal.
I was just one concerned citizen doing what he had to.
You used me to get that confession. If anybody finds out about it, there won't be a trial. So, where's Dwight Tully?
Jail.
Winston?
Where are you safe?
You work fast.
And a compliment?
Just a professional observation.
So, what now? What are you going to do?
I'm gonna have another drink. And then I'm gonna go home and write my story. About Dwight Tully.
Said when he was in the prison camp in Korea, the only thing that kept him going day after day was making up stories about the life he would have when he got free. I guess that's all John Morgan's doing.
That's what any of us do day after day. In a way, we're all prisoners of one kind or another. We keep on pretending till the war is over and we get to go home.